If you suffer from muscle-related pelvic pain, you know that conventional medicine, whose remedies are primarily limited to drugs, procedures, and surgery, have offered little to help those who deal with muscle-related pelvic pain. In this video, I want to discuss an insight that I believe makes pelvic pain syndromes understandable to the layperson. I think it explains why drugs, surgery, and procedures have not been effective, and it helps clarify in simple terms the rationale and the success of the treatment we developed at Stanford. Our treatment was originally called the Wise-Anderson Protocol, but was popularly called the Stanford Protocol for many years. We have all seen a dog pull his tail between his legs when he is fearful. Sometimes people have attributed this tail pulled between the legs behavior to shame, submission, dread, defeat, or shyness. However, I believe the common denominator running through the various emotions associated with an animal pulling its tail between its legs is fear. Sometimes fear is called stress, anxiety, worry, emotional upset, nervousness, but for our discussion here, I'm going to call it fear. To my knowledge, in the scientific discussion of pelvic pain, there has been no discussion of what we believe to be the intimate relationship between the tail pulled between the legs behavior, anxiety, and pelvic pain. This is what I am proposing here, that the origin of a preponderance of muscle-related pelvic pain comes from an instinctive, protective, biological reaction to pull in the tail in states of fear or stress, resulting in pelvic pain when this pulling in goes on too long. I'll explain further. Walter Cannon, who was a great physiologist at Harvard at the beginning of the 20th century, introduced the famous phrase fight, flight, freeze to describe the varieties of survival behavior in humans, among other mammals. He noticed that when a person feels threatened, the instinctive reaction is either to fight, to run away, which is fleeing or flight, or freeze and wait for the danger to go away. Fight, flight, freeze. When a cat or dog, for instance, pulls its tail between its legs, in terms of fight, flight, freeze, the animal is more in the freeze mode. The animal is neither running away nor fighting. This freeze behavior expresses the animal's attempt to self-protectively withdraw, hold fast, while waiting for the danger to pass. In contrast, most dog or cat owners know their animal is feeling excited or aggressive when its tail is waving. Most cat or dog owners usually read their animal's emotional states by paying close attention to what the tail is doing. Interesting, the phrase a tail between the legs is common in many languages to describe behaviors of fear, shame, submission, cowardice, or defeat. In humans, the tailbone is commonly understood to be what remains of the tail that has been inherited from our humanoid ancestors. This tailbone, or technically it's called the coccyx, is sometimes called the vestigial tail. I reiterate that pulling the tail between the legs requires muscle contraction in the pelvis. If you tighten your pelvic muscles while holding your finger on your tailbone, you will notice that your tailbone pulls in. In terms of evolution, the tail pulled between the legs is an active behavior associated with fear. The aim of pulling the tail between the legs is probably to protect the anal rectal area and genitals, as well as a way that the animal signals to a predator or competitor that it is no longer a threat or a competitor. From the beginning of our research, we have known that somehow pelvic pain was related to chronic self-protective muscle tension that formed a self-feeding cycle of tension, anxiety, pain, and protective guarding. In the original publication of our book, A Headache in the Pelvis, in 2003, we summarized our understanding in this way, quote, we have identified a group of chronic pelvic pain syndromes that we believe is caused by the overuse of the human instinct to protect the genitals, rectum, and contents of the pelvis from injury or pain by contracting the pelvic muscles. This tendency becomes exaggerated in predisposed individuals, and over time, it results in chronic pelvic pain and dysfunction. The state of chronic constriction creates pain-referring trigger points, reduced blood flow, and an inhospitable environment for the nerves and blood vessels and structures throughout the pelvic basin. This results in a cycle of tension, anxiety, and pain which has previously been unrecognized and untreated. Understanding this tension, anxiety, and pain cycle has allowed us to create an effective treatment. Our program breaks the cycle by rehabilitating the shortened pelvic muscles and connective tissue supporting the pelvic organs while simultaneously using a specific methodology to modify the tendency to tighten the muscles of the pelvic floor under stress. Now, what I'm saying here about the relationship between anxiety and pulling the tail between the legs is an elaboration of our original insight. Once these muscles remain contracted too long and too strongly, what we describe in most detail in the fifth edition of our book as tension, anxiety, pain, and protective guarding cycle is set in motion. Pain prompts you to tighten up the pelvis protectively, which makes the discomfort worse, which typically triggers anxiety, which makes the pain and protective guarding worse, which then feeds itself. This cycle tends to have a life of its own, even after the initial stress is gone, unless appropriately treated, as we have found most effectively by the patient, him or herself, on a regular basis until the symptoms abate. Once this cycle gets established, it tends to flare up under stress, even when it goes away for periods of time. This tendency is the reason why we emphasize patient self-treatment, where the patient is able to reduce or resolve a flare-up in him or herself without the flare-up becoming long-standing and putting one's life on hold. Now, what is the practical application of the understanding of the relationship between anxiety, a tail pulled between the legs, and pelvic pain? This relationship underscores the necessity of rehabilitating the relevant pelvic muscles responsible for chronically pulling in the tailbone. In my view, it underscores the necessity of modifying the patient's tendency toward anxiety and catastrophic thinking that feeds this chronic muscle tension. Freeing up all of the muscles inside and outside the pelvic floor that have become painful and restricted is critical to resolving the pain and dysfunction of pelvic pain syndromes. Freeing the muscles attached to the tailbone is particularly important in treating what you can call posterior symptoms, or symptoms that are found in the back. Symptoms like sitting pain, post-bowel movement pain, and general pain in the rectum and anus. In summary, I am proposing that there is a self-protective biological reflex in human beings involving pulling the tail between the legs when someone is chronically stressed or anxious. The muscular activity of pulling the tail between the legs when done chronically can cause painful shortening and contraction of the muscles associated with pulling the tailbone in. This chronic contraction can cause all kinds of weird symptoms, from urinary frequency and urgency, sitting pain, post-bowel movement pain, pain in the anorectal area, discomfort with sexual activity, and other kinds of symptoms that humans simply never experience unless their pelvic muscles have been in a chronic and ongoing state of contraction. People without pelvic pain who have not chronically tightened up their pelvic floor muscles don't get it when you try to explain pelvic pain symptoms to them. This is one of the reasons why when you have pelvic pain, you feel so isolated. When we physically examine the muscles related to pulling in the tailbone in our patients, these muscles are commonly the most trigger-pointed, shortened, and painful of muscles. In our physical therapy protocol, we typically are able to recreate pain associated with sitting, post-bowel movement pain, tailbone pain, and sometimes genital and or perineal discomfort, and of course, anal rectal discomfort in pelvic pain patients by palpating the muscles most closely associated with pulling in the tailbone. Of course, there are many people who primarily have anterior symptoms, and those are symptoms toward the front, including genital discomfort, bladder or suprapubic or abdominal discomfort, groin discomfort, urinary frequency urgency, discomfort associated with sexual activity and orgasm. You need to engage all of the muscles of the pelvic floor in order to pull in the tail. These kinds of anterior symptoms can occur simultaneously with or independent of the posterior symptoms, and they must be released of trigger points and areas of restriction equally. Furthermore, pelvic pain that is triggered by trauma or injury to the pelvis rather than by chronic anxiety also can trigger this protective tail pull between the legs behavior that otherwise occurs in states of chronic anxiety or fear. The thorough release and healing of the tail pull between the leg muscles, in our experience, is ultimately done best by patients themselves as we instruct them in the Wise Anderson protocol. A person's conditioning and what has usually become a habitual tendency to tighten the muscles of the pelvic floor under stress must be changed. Our protocol trains our patients in paradoxical relaxation in order to help them relax the pelvic floor and gets it used to not being in a state of pull, shortness, constriction, or contraction. People who have tightened their pelvic muscles for a long time have to get their mind and their conditioning to agree with having a relaxed pelvis. This is no small task. So, in summary, I have drawn a relationship here between pelvic pain in humans and the animal behavior of pulling the tail between the legs related to states of fear. Pulling the tail between the legs is a muscular event. The rehabilitation of these muscles and the modification of the tendency to chronically pull the tail in under stress are essential to the resolution of pelvic pain.